Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to look at the new Google Earth app that's found right within the Chrome app box. So let's get started with the mini lesson. So to find this new Google Earth app that runs right within your Chromebook, simply go over to the Google Apps. Now if you don't see your little Google Apps icon there, you can go to a new tab or go to www.google.com. And once you're at google.com, click it. And if you don't see it in the first section, simply click on More, and then there it is. Click it, and it will start the Google Earth app. Let me show you some of the wonderful things that we can do and play with on this little globe here. Now, many of you might be familiar with the one that you use on the Windows desktop. And in the past, we weren't able to actually use this within a Chromebook. Well, that's all changed. And I'm going to show you some of the features here. So you take this little man here. If you zoom in a little bit here towards California, and I'm going to drop the little man there. Okay, now we're in Reedley, California, and I can of course look around. This is the exact same thing as we see in Street View. Let's go ahead and let's turn off the man, fly up above it, and notice down here in the lower corner where the globe's at, we could turn on 3D. And now it looks like I have a 3D map rolling right in front of me. So far it's exactly the same as you'd find in a Windows machine. The only difference is, of course, this is on a Chromebook, so that's why I'm so excited, because in the past I wasn't able to do this. The menu over on the left-hand side, if I click it there, you can actually see there we have a search, the Voyager, My Places, Map Style, Photos, and other things there. Let's go in, and this is the search. I was able to search other places if you already know the name. On the Voyager, it's pretty amazing because the Voyager, you can actually do travel and see things like as if you just took a trip there. So it really saves a lot of money. And you can actually do a walkthrough. So I was able to drop the little man onto a beach in Hawaii and then walk down the beach on Hawaii there. So it was great. There's nature here. We can explore caves, different islands, different other things here. It's just amazing. You can even explore space. You can look at different cultures. So if you want to learn about culture and history, about the cultures. And with education, you can learn much more about like earlier explorers such as Lewis and Clark, or dinosaurs, or other things. So this has a high educational value. And if you like learning, which I do, I think this is actually a very good app. The last one that we have here is history. You can explore some historical sites. Click Explore. So here's the 3D view. And then over here we have the history about this area and what we know about it. So I'm going to click on Search. And I'm going to type in the name of a town. And let's fly there. And this is in Japan. So why Tanushima Harumachi? Because this is my in-laws' house right here, and this is where we go during the summers. So let's say that I wanted to take the little man and I can drop him there. I can look around in the street view. If you click back on the man, it starts flying out. And you can look around the area in this kind of futuristic 3D view here. And it really looks just like you have a little map of the city and you're just manipulating it around in front of you. It's really amazing. Well, this video was created using my new Acer Chromebook 15 with touchscreen, and I just completed a review of using this machine here. Now, about Google Earth, it has many of the same features that you find in Google Maps as well as other Google services. The difference here is their focus on education and learning. So you can actually go in and learn much more about the history and other facts about these places. Well, if you're watching this on YouTube, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, and share the video. Thank you again, and bye-bye.